Hey, I'm Lauren.
Hey, I'm Ashley, and welcome back to True Events, where we discuss non-fictional movies and series.
Grab some popcorn and relax as we dive into this week's episode of the 2010 film, The Social Network, directed by David Fincher.
A brief summary about The Social Network is that it's based on a Harvard student named Mark Zuckerberg, who was in his sophomore year while creating the website called FaceSmash by hacking into college database to steal photos of females students, then allowing site visitors to rate their attractiveness. Due to this act, he ends up getting caught by the dean and gets put on academic probation. It attracts the attention of the twins Cameron and Tyler Voss and their business partner Divya Narendra. The twins have an idea to create Harvard Connection, a social network exclusive to Harvard students and aimed at dating, and they want Mark's help to create the website.
Mark gives the twins excuses and begins to work on an idea that he had, which was later known as the Facebook. Mark works with his best friend Eduardo Saverin and his roommate Dustin Moskovitz to bring the idea of the Facebook to life. Mark and Eduardo meet up with an entrepreneur, Sean Parker, who will help bring into light the website, the Facebook. Little did Mark know that his actions would catch up to him and take him to court. Mark has to deal with two court cases as he is being sued by the Winklevoss twins and their partner, Divya Narendran, and is also being sued by his best friend, Eduardo Saverin.
Some background information is that Mark Zuckerberg was born on May 14, 1984, in White Plains, New York. Zuckerberg began using computers and writing softwares in middle school. In high school, he built a program that allowed all computers between his house and his father's dental office to communicate with each other. During Zuckerberg's high school years, he worked to build a music player called the Synapse Media Player. The device used machines learning to learn the user's listening habits, which was posted to the Slashdot and received a rating of 3 out of 5 from PC Magazine. Can you imagine that, Lauren? Like, just building softwares and creating programs and being all into like the computer and like, I don't know, like just how to create websites from middle school and continue to do it throughout high school.
You know, like that wasn't even like a time where like technology was like popular, but like he was already like, you know, really creating these like new just like new inventions really ahead of his time, I would say.
Yeah, definitely.
A New Yorker profile said of Zuckerberg, "Some kids played with computers, Mark created them." Zuckerberg began classes at Harvard in 2002. He had already achieved a reputation as a programming prodigy. He studied psychology and computer science. In his sophomore year, he wrote a program that he called Course Match, which allowed users to make class selection decisions based on the choices of other students and also to help them form study groups. A short time later, he created a different program he initially called FaceSmash, which lets students select the best looking person from a choice of photos. Wow, that's like an invasion of privacy, kind of.
Yeah, and it's kind of disrespectful. Like, imagine seeing that when you live on campus in that university.
I'd be kind of offended.
Yeah, well, I mean, like nowadays, no, yeah, I think anybody would be offended. I was kind of gonna say, kind of like nowadays, like, you know how like everything changed and how this new generation like definitely changed a lot, but no, yeah, I could still see like people getting offended by it.
You know, especially because like they didn't have social media back then, so it's like they just had the internet. They didn't have any like, you know, social media accounts, so it's like they had to really like dig to get those photos, and then
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure they felt like kind of violated.
Yeah. And also, like, I don't know, like maybe those people didn't have some confidence. Like maybe they
Maybe,
felt self-conscious about themselves, and this website, this little program that he made, just made them even more self-conscious. And what I find interesting that it was just women.
I know.
There wasn't
That's
any
the
men on that, like, to rate.
I know. He's really, yeah, I don't know.
Mark's best friend Eduardo Saverin was born on March 19, 1982 in Brazil. He came from a wealthy family, which drove Mark to ask him for funding money for the website that they will make later on. Due to the trouble that Mark created with his face mash program, he got in a lot of trouble with the Harvard dean, which then later resulted with him being on academic probation. This chaos drew attention to Mark, not only from everyone, but also from the twins Cameron and Tyler Winklevoss and their partner Divya Narendra.
The Winklevoss twins came from an extremely wealthy family. The Winklevoss and Divya come to Mark with their idea of Harvard Connect, a website exclusive to Harvard students and aimed at dating. Mark somewhat agrees to help with creating Harvard Connect, but goes to his dorm as he thought of something better. Mark thinks of a way to make something greater yet similar to Harvard Connect. That is when the idea of the Facebook popped into his creative mind.
What do you think about that?
He's basically stealing kind of like their idea and calling it his.
Yeah, because he like changed a little bit. He changed a little bit of it, but
yeah, exactly. But yeah,
it still came from like the same idea. Mark ends up working with Eduardo and his roommates Andrew McCollum, Dustin Moskovitz, and Chris Hughes to help create the website. They need funding money to create the website, so Mark turns to Eduardo to invest $1,000 on the site. Thus, the Facebook launched during 2004. Everyone on Harvard campus finds out about the amazing website and begins to use it. However, since everyone begins to use it, that is how the Winklevoss twins and their partner Divya find out about their idea being stolen.
Wow, I'd be so pissed if I was the Winklevoss.
Like, having to find out off other people, or not even other people, like just looking over their shoulder like and see what they're doing.
Yeah. I'd just be like, what? I just told him my idea and he goes and steals it. Like, how dare he?
Yeah, and the fact that, well, the movie states that Mark was like avoiding them while he was working on the website, it's just like it gives them more more reasons to be angry at him.
Exactly. As Mark and Eduardo are planning to expand the website to other schools around the country, the Winklevoss twins are planning to file a lawsuit against Mark. Later, Zuckerberg and Saverin each agree to invest another $18,000 in the operation. As co-founder, Saverin holds the role of chief financial officer and business manager. Eduardo wants to add advertisement, while Mark wants to continue to expand to a website before adding advertisement, which leads for the both to meet up with the entrepreneur and co-founder of Napster, Sean Parker.
Sean Parker is willing to help the website expand not only to other universities, but also to other countries. He presents a billion-dollar vision for the company and the idea to drop the word the and to just name the website Facebook. Mark starts leaning towards Sean and away from Eduardo, leading to problems within their friendship and business relationship. Mark dilutes Eduardo's share and kept everyone's the way it was from the beginning. Wow.
Wow. His true colors are really showing.
They are.
Yeah.
The fact that he starts leaning away from his friend who was there since the beginning and helping him create the website and starts leaning towards somebody that just has, you know, some pain. Like, I don't know. It's just...
Yeah, it's like, I don't know. He doesn't sound like... He's, like, not really a true friend, like, to Eduardo. I feel like he's just kind of in it for himself, like, the money and, like, maybe some fame, you know?
Yeah, I could see that. Especially since, like... Sean Parker's like just basically like filling their head with the idea that he is like this entrepreneur and who he had worked with before and like the billion-dollar vision that he has for the company. Like, I feel like all of that maybe got into Mark's head. And also the fact that he told him that he can help him expand to other countries. I feel like that made Mark just start to close his mind and start thinking that he could grow this website a lot more without Eduardo.
Yeah, that for sure sold him on that. He was like, say less, like, you know. But yeah. So this leads to Eduardo suing Mark for what had occurred, and Sean takes Eduardo's place as president of the company. Mark drops Sean as he is related to drugs and sleeping with minors and for being unprofessional. Mark goes to court and deals with two cases at once against the Winklevoss twins and their partner, and against Eduardo. After what seemed like a never-ending court case, Winklevoss twins agreed to a settlement of $65 million and signed a non-disclosure agreement.
So it basically just went like everything that he did with Eduardo, like losing a friendship, like I guess gaining somewhat a relationship with like regarding business with Sean, like all of that just went to the trash.
Yeah, it ended up biting him in the
Yeah, like although he got what he wanted, it came with consequences.
for sure. And I think that, like, I don't even think that was worth it. Like, he's really young too at that age, and he just got himself into so much like bull, and like it's gonna like take a lot to like get out of it. Like, he has two lawsuits against him. I can't imagine having one lawsuit against me.
I know, like I don't know, it's just, and to think like this isn't his first time being in trouble because of something that he had created. Like, just think about how we talked about the face smash. He got in trouble with the dean and he got put on academic probation. And now this whole chaos with the website Facebook,
I
like
know.
his creativity also comes with consequences.
Yeah, it came with a price, and then like we're seeing that now with all these like lawsuits.
Yeah, I mean he could afford it, but
I know, huh? He probably
but
could.
why,
But
like
like, why
why, be
even? Yeah.
why what?
Like, why even? Like, if like you know, it's not worth like it. And yeah.
Eduardo receives an unknown settlement and has his name placed on the masthead as Facebook's co-founder. Mark not only owns Facebook, but he recently created Meta Platform Incorporations, which includes Facebook Messenger, Instagram, which he actually bought back in 2012, and WhatsApp, which he also bought back in 2014.
Well,
I heard about the Meta the Platforms Co Incorporation and like what apps it had included, but I didn't know that he bought them. I thought he created them for some reason.
wow. Yeah, I know. He ended up like buying a lot of like different apps.
Yeah. I mean, he does have the money to like bribe them.
Yeah, for sure.
I believe he bought like percentages of the app. I don't think he bought the whole app.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. Like, I don't know. Yeah, I think he did buy like percentages because like if you made an app that you know attracts billions and billions and billions of views or people, like you wouldn't just sell it for like billions of dollars. Like you would be like, now you could get half, but you still have to pay me.
Yeah, because they'd be like, I made too much money off this. I'm not gonna just give it to you for like, you know, you can't put a price on it, you know? Probably that's what
Yeah.
I think.
Especially since it's like a billionaire like Mark Zuckerberg that's trying to buy your app. Like, it
True.
wouldn't be smart for that person to just sell it to him. It would be better to like make profit and make more money sharing percentages with him while still owning the app.
Yeah, exactly.
That way, like you're receiving money from, I believe, like, you're receiving money from, or you received an enormous amount of money from Mark, and you're also receiving money from like everyone else in play.
Yeah.
Okay, so overall, how did you feel about the film, Lauren?
I thought it was an interesting story because like it's based on Mark Zuckerberg and how he like just became this really big, like successful billionaire. I kind of didn't like how he stole the twins' idea. I didn't know that's like how he like got the idea for Facebook and like how he kind of like over his best friend just for like some money and fame or whatever he was doing it for, because he was kind of being like selfish and greedy. So I was just like, oh, that's like not cool, you know? But overall, I think it was a good film. You know, it just shows his story on his life and how he came about, you know, creating these like social networks, like these like apps that like we use like on the daily. I think it's crazy.
Yeah, it definitely is.
Mm-hmm. What about you? How do you feel about it?
Just like you. Well, I watched this movie when I was younger, but I don't remember anything until recently since we just watched it. But I thought that Mark created Facebook on his own, you know, like it was just like an idea that popped in his mind. Mm-hmm. And to know that he stole it, he basically stole a similar type of idea from the twins, just somewhat quote unquote made it better. It's just, I don't know, it's just really disgusting in a way. Because can you just imagine like telling your story to someone or telling an idea to somebody and like they make it and they get like billions and billions of dollars and they get recognition and a lot of awards for what they have done and you're just sitting on the side and they're like, who are you?
It would kill me. I'd be like so mad and infuriated. But it does happen.
Yeah, sadly it does.
Yeah.
And also just like seeing how the friendship between Mark and Eduardo deteriorated for something that is related to money. You know how they always say like money sometimes breaks up relationships or I don't know, something like that. Friendships, families. It's sadly true.
I know, money will like, I don't know. Money,
drive people crazy.
Yeah, the things people will do for money.
Mm-hmm. Money and fame.
Yeah, money is evil. I'm just kidding. or there's a saying, I think money is the root of all evil.
I think so, yeah. I think that is the saying.
Yeah, I could see that.
Yeah. Did it make any connection while watching the film with another situation or another person?
Not really. I just think that... I think he's really like influential, I guess, like in, because he's like, he like Facebook, I think, because, well, like I feel like before Facebook it was MySpace, but I wasn't really using I'd never used MySpace or Facebook, but I would hear a lot about Facebook like growing up, and then like, you know, it was really big, it became very big and popular, like everyone had it. So I thought you know, it's pretty, you know, big thing to do, like to make. I just think like that he kind of made like history, honestly. Like he created this like this social network and like everyone's using it and everyone's talking about it. So I think that he just, I mean, I don't want to give him all credit because like, you know, it wasn't like fully his idea. It was also like the twins.
Yeah.
So like them too, I guess they could get some credit. So I don't want to give him all credit, but like, yeah, he just like really kind of, I guess he just pushed for it and like, but I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, he basically did like create history because he is the youngest, I believe, if he's still not the youngest, but he was the youngest self-made billionaire by the age of 23.
Wow, that's crazy.
I know.
It's so young to be a billionaire.
It is. Like, mm-hmm. We're barely graduating college by then.
I know, huh? He's like, did he finish college? Yeah, right? Or did he stop? He was like, oh, okay.
I believe he graduated from Harvard.
Oh, well, that's so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, because honestly, I feel like if that was me, I would have been like, bye, college. I'm a billionaire. Like,
I'm done here.
Yeah.
That would be funny. I made a connection with the film,
mm-hmm.
or the situation, sadly, but it wasn't another film or another person. It was me. Yeah, I recently had to do like a project group work. My partner basically did nothing, and it was so hard for me to get in contact with them because they wouldn't answer. Like, they would answer, but after hours, honestly.
Oh, wow. That must have been annoying for you.
Yeah, it kind of was, but I didn't really like, I'm not the type of person to like tell the person anything. I'm more just of the person to like hold it in, and I'm like, okay, whatever, it happened, you know?
Well, I'm sorry you had to go through that.
It's fine. I didn't become a billionaire, but...
Not yet.
Hopefully, fingers crossed. But yeah. Do you have any opinions about the film or the situation?
I guess, like, going back to what you said, like, I didn't know he, like, kind of stole someone's idea. Like, I thought he just created it, like, all on his own. Mm-hmm. So when I was watching it and I saw that, I was like, oh, wow, like, it made me think kind of differently of him. I'm like, oh, man, like, he didn't really do it on his own. Like, he, like, stole someone's, like, idea in a way. So I was like, oh, man, like, I thought he, you know, and created everything on his own. But, I guess just that, like, him, and then, like, not giving credit to, like, you know, the people who had the, like, the idea that he kind of, or part of the idea that he stole. That and, like, how he kind of, you know, I guess kind of backstabbed his friend in a way. Uh-huh. Like, wow, that's crazy. Like, I didn't know that, like, you know, and, like, this really happened, so, like, I can't imagine that, like, being in, like, maybe Eduardo's position, like, having your friend and, like, you guys, like, talking about this idea you guys have, and you guys are gonna create it, and then, like, the other, your friend just, like, taking all the credit and giving you, like, kind of nothing. I'd just be so, like, heartbroken and just, yeah, and I'd be like, wow, what the hell? Like, I thought you were my friend, you know?
Yeah.
But, yeah. Say, it also kind of shows, like, the person, I guess, he is. Like, he's, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like... I don't know if he is that same person now, but, like, I can kind of see him, if he is, I can kind of see him still being the person now, like, just being very kind of greedy and just, like, wants everything to himself. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's kind of, like, the image it painted of him in my head.
Yeah. I agree with you. I mean, the friendship that he had with Eduardo, and he just, like, threw it all away for something that... I would say basically has, like, it does have a value because it basically gave him a different life and he could provide his family with a lot of things and, you know, his position where he is right now. But it doesn't really have a lot of value at the same time because it's a thing. And mm-hmm. I feel like something that has value is, you know, friendships and family and people that you love.
Yeah.
So, exactly. Yeah, so, sorry, my bone cracked. I do agree with you on that aspect. Also, with what you were saying, like, it just changed your perspective on Mark. I was thinking, like, we know who directed the film, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which was David Fincher.
Mm-hmm.
However... we don't really know who wrote The Social Network.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, like, you get me?
Yeah.
Like, what do they base it off on? Just of what everyone knows, like, on a Wikipedia? Yeah. Or was it actually Mark who helped the people that created The Social Network, you know, create the vision and make it come to life? Or if they're just giving their opinion about what had happened.
Yeah, I don't know, honestly. I just feel like maybe, yeah, they probably did, like, go off base, like, what they know what happens. But, like, maybe, I don't know if they got, like, Mark Zuckerberg's, like real story. Or maybe they did, and Mark is, like, I don't know. I don't know, honestly.
Yeah, it's, like, it's... I mean, it is something known, like, what had happened between these people happened, right?
Mm-hmm.
But we don't know who basically told this story in this form, you know? Like, the story in real life could have been a different way, in a way. Yeah. Somehow. They could, I don't, like, know how.
Yeah, like, altered some stuff, like... maybe that didn't happen in some scenes, you know, or maybe it did, you know, you never know, really.
Yeah, but who knows? I mean, the real people know.
Yeah, exactly.
I completely agree with you on that aspect. And also, I feel like, to add something really quickly, in the film, they always tell him that his ex-girlfriend in the beginning, she tells him, girls are not gonna break up with you or are not gonna like you because you're nerdy. They're gonna break up with you or treat you wrongly because you're an a-hole, basically.
Oh yeah, honestly.
And I was thinking the whole time, because that's how, like, in the film Mark was portrayed, like this type of nerdy kid, but was also acting, you know, like really douchey, you get me? And like I was trying to like think why he would act that way. And people who are portrayed or titled as the nerd in real life, even, or people that are being bullied, at one point they get tired and they start to give like a non-emotional type of person, like they try to paint themselves like a person that is strong and hard and they don't care about anything or anyone. Or and I believe that people do that to protect themselves. Like, it comes to a point where like they just have enough and they know they don't want to do anything, or they don't want to do anything to like just not to be that person, but like they try to protect themselves in a way, but they start hurting other people.
Yeah, I could see that, like he's using that kind of like as a like a method to not get like hurt, I guess, by people. He just is like very closed off and like cold.
Yeah.
So like, yeah, it's kind of like a shield, I guess, he uses just to like Yeah, I could definitely see that. Yeah. And what like his girlfriend said, like him being like an a-hole, I can see that, because like she's like the one that kind of like states that in the beginning, and then we see that throughout the movie, like, oh dang, he is kind of an a-hole. Like,
yeah,
yeah,
but once again, the only people that know are, just how I said during our podcast of Pam and Tommy, the only people that really know the story are the people that are part of the story.
Yeah, that it actually happened too. I agree with that. Yeah, because like, I don't know, I feel like Hollywood sometimes, like, you know,
alters,
like, yeah, alters the story, like maybe just for like dramatic effect, or like maybe maybe it didn't happen, or maybe they're like, yeah, not being like truthful for whatever reason why, like, you know, it's always like a different story told by them, whereas yeah, like, it's actually made by like, you know, the real people that it happened to, that it's based off of. That's like when it's like more authentic, I think.
Or it can actually like also, like, they're getting the story from another person that is trying to paint the one of like the main characters as a bad guy.
Yeah, that happens a lot, honestly.
Yeah. But that's it for today's episode of the 2010 film The Social Network.
Tune in for the next episode, where we will be discussing the 2019 film Extremely Wicked and Shockingly Evil and Vile.
Thank you for listening to True Events. Bye.
Bye.